Okay, so now we're going to convert a denary number into hexadecimal. And again, like last time, I've got the hexadecimal numbers on the right-hand side here, or digits. And down here, I've got a hexadecimal table. And this is very similar to the binary table. So in the binary table, as you know, it starts on 1, then goes to 2, then 4, then 8, then 16, then 32, and it doubles each time. Hexadecimal is slightly different. It times itself by 16 every time. So 1 times 16 is 16. 16 times 16 is 256. 256 times 16 is that. And that times 16 is whatever, a big number. It can kind of carry on like the binary table does. So we'll take the example of 213 as a denary number that we're going to convert. Now, what we have to do is do a bit of division on this by 16. Okay, so every time you get a denary number, we have to divide it by 16. So let's have a look. How many 16s in 2? None. So we'll carry the 2 over here. How many 16s in 21. So we know we have 1. And where are we? 16. So we got 5 to carry over. Okay. So how many 16s in 53? So we have 3. Which takes us up to 48. So 48, 53, so we have a remainder of 5. Okay, so 53 take 48 is 5. So we got 13, remainder 5. Okay, so what we can do now is we can look that up on our table over here for hexadecimal numbers. So we know 13... Let's look across, and 13 is equal to D. Okay, so we would write D, and we do the same for 5. So 5 is just equal to 5, so we would write that there. Okay, so the answer to our conversion is D5. Okay, so 213 converted to hexadecimal is D5.